My best of 2018 top picks are here for drugstore, high-end, and luxury. I added a few more, just like I did last year, as far as depending on what I particularly do with my own makeup and skin prep routine. So in the event you're interested in those as well, I hope it helps you out. Number one is going to be my skin prep sprays. And this is where I actually, it's specific to my makeup routine because I spray it on my face first as a primer, as a pre-step, whatever skin boosting it offers. This category is going to stay in the high end. And it's my Smashbox Primer Water as well as my MAC Charged Water. Every time I do my makeup, I actually rotate and change through my products. That is the way you're going to go ahead and notice you're going to finish up your products. So I just interchange between the MAC and the Smashbox. I equally like them both. I really do. And I just can't pick between one or the other. Number two is going to be an actual skin primer. So this is going to be a step if you actually do. At the drugstore, my top pick for hydration is going to go to J. Katz H2O Fresh Dewy Base Primer. This is like a bucket of water. I've said that before. A bucket of water has just been thrown into your face. This is major hydration. However, it's the texture of it that I like. It's a texture that is like a hybrid of a gel and a cream. And then it's right when you just start to rub it out into your skin, just like I do skincare, I press and pat it into my skin. That is when you feel the water. It's a strong feeling and I like that. And then it just starts to go into the skin and then I go right in with makeup application. I wanted to include something from the actual drugstore for what I would recommend that will cover all skin types, so you just don't have to worry about the extra hydration. So when it comes to that drugstore pick, mine still remains the same like it was for last year, and it's the Maybelline Master Prime. Just go pick which one you maybe want to focus on with your own skin condition, sort of like how you would with your actual skincare. So illuminate, blur, or more hydration depending on your skin type. But this will offer enough, I feel, to make a nice base onto the skin for you to then go in with your makeup application. My high-end pick goes to Laura Mercier, and this is our foundation primer. This is actually the Radiance one, and I also have just the regular one without a Radiance. This doesn't irritate the skin. It's in a lot of makeup artists' kit, so it covers a lot of different skin types, almost said skin tones. It doesn't have a tint to it. Skin types. But again, it's something where it will cover all the basics. And then you can go ahead and have a nice smooth base and apply your foundation. Next up is corrector. Now for drugstore, I didn't really go venturing into that arena. I was focusing more on staying with the products that were already in my collection. But I do have one for my high-end pick. This is the one that I did pick up last year. This is from Makeup Forever. It's the Ultra HD Invisible Cover Concealer. Now this is in the shade R50, so the red category. This is where it's going to offer that tone for my warm skin tone. It will cover whatever I'm trying to do. As far as a blemish or a dark spot, I lightly set this with some loose powder, which this formula will actually lay down flat when you do that. And then I will go in with either a little bit of extra foundation on the brush or sponge, or I will go in with an actual concealer and it's just covered and it's not going to budge. I'm adding in two extra categories because it is what I do with my makeup application. So first will be my foundation moisture prep products. And then of course I have my products that I will add into that actual foundation. So I like to call it my mixture combo. For the moisture prep, I do have a drugstore one, and this is from Aveeno. It's their Positively Radiant Max Glow Infusion Drops. Gives me hydration, but it's just the overall look on my skin, the dewiness that it produces. It's not overly dewy, but it's enough for me. And I have just, on no makeup days, put this on my skin for that hydration, done. Just makes my skin look so good. I just cannot be without it, and I really hope it does not get discontinued. My high-end pick for the moisture combo is still my pick from the prior year, and this is my Belief Creams, the Aqua Bomb. Another one where it's that drink of water. Lightweight texture, moisturizes the skin. It's what I use the most with my Fenty foundation. I know if I'm gonna pull my Fenty foundation to use for that day, that is pretty much the only moisture that I'll put on my skin as my primer, because it pairs so good with the Fenty formula. For my add-in to my foundation products, my top drugstore pick goes to L'Oreal True Match Lumi Glow Lotion. Now I have the shade Deep. This comes in 3 shades. I have reviewed this. Anything that I've already have reviewed, I'll either make sure the link is in the info box, or what you can do is go to the search function, type in the title of whatever the product is, and then the video will pop up. So just to let you know, you can focus it on your face as far as, let's say, all over your face. I would go lightly. You can focus it as a highlighter. You can drop it and mix it in with your foundation, which is what I really love to do. And it's just that subtle touch, but it's subtle enough where it's not so alarming, but definitely you can see it. My high-end pick is going to go to my Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter. Now it says it's a Superstar Youth Glow. It will change the texture of my foundations, the ones that are just like thicker, the ones that are drier, the ones I just want to toss, but I'm like, okay, I'm not going to toss it because I spent the money on it. I will mix this in there and it will change the texture. So that's personally what I prefer to do. So again, I just say, think of it as that. Either use it by itself on your skin in lieu of everything else, or mix it in with something and see if that's how you like it. For foundation, I actually split it for stick foundation as well as regular liquid. My foundation pick, drugstore top pick, goes to NYX's Can't Stop, Won't Stop foundation. So they're able to have this formula where it can help still create that skin-like appearance. But the reason why I chose this is actually because of the environment, the elements. I was remembering when I would wear this foundation the most is during the summer. Where I live, it's pretty much summer year round, but when it's in the summer months and it is hot, and I was going every Sunday to the concerts in the park, and I'm out there dancing and I'm sweating, and sometimes I would wear makeup. Actually, most of the time for the park, I did wear makeup, and I chose this foundation, and I would look in my mirror thinking, oh, I need to blot. No, it's stayed put till I came home that night and washed it off. That is what impressed me, where I was like, you know what? This is the top pick for 2018. I have to include a dewy version, a radiant type of foundation, because that's me. That is my top choice. So for that pick, the drugstore physician's formula, the healthy foundation. Sometimes I forget how good this is. You know, we have so many foundations, but when I want to go for a nice dewy appearance on my skin, when I want to put something on where it's just going to melt, where it's just going to go in with my skin tone, with my undertone, really look good on the skin, and I just don't have to worry about it. Just go about my business. This is the one I pick. So definitely prefer this one. Now for high end, my pick goes to the one that I could not get out of my head. I couldn't get it out. And every time I would go to Sephora, I was getting samples to the point I was like, girl, just go and get the foundation. It goes to Marc Jacobs, Shameless Foundation. Now this is also one that I already did a review. I am in the shade Tan Y480. This is another foundation that gives me that skin-like appearance that I like. Perfect shade for my skin. I get compliments when I wear it, like I'm having a good skin day. It is a really good foundation. When it comes to stick foundations, I prefer to just to continue using what I already have in my collection. I don't want a ton of sticks, but there was one stick foundation that stood out for 2018, and it's actually up there with my all-time favorite, the Bobbi Brown stick foundation, and it's good old color. ColourPop. This is their No Filter Foundation Stick. I'm in the shade Dark 175W. I can't tell you how many times I have reached for this stick. It's so fast. It blends quick. Perfect shade again. You'll see that a broken record with me, but with me, my skin needs to be matching up to the actual shade. Not only is it skin-like again, it's a little bit slight dew, and I don't have to add anything else onto my skin, in with the foundation. Not that I would, you know, put it on the stick, but you see what I mean? It goes on like, I was like, oh, little dewy there. Looks good on the skin. For concealer, I have one drugstore and one high-end. My top pick will be the shade expansion from Maybelline's Age Rewind Concealer. I'm in the shade Tan. This is actually another product I've already did a dedicated video with all of the deeper shades. This is a concealer that will work for underneath my eyes. It's not drying underneath my eyes. It covers what I feel I need to cover underneath my eye area. But best of all, it is a fabulous spot concealer. Whether I use the sponge, whether I dip in a sponge, excuse me, attached to it, or I dip in with my brush, I can even put a tiny bit of foundation with it and it covers it up just like a high-end concealer. So definitely love the Age Rewind. Just so glad that they expanded the shade so that I can at least, well, you know, people in my medium dark series can enjoy it. We still need more additional shades because people with rich deep skin tones, you know, can't benefit from using that product. So Maybelline, I'm getting on you again. You do have some expansions to do with that product, but it is definitely my top pick. My high-end pick will be from Urban Decay. It's their all-nighter waterproof full coverage concealer. Another product I went ahead and did a full review on. They did send me all the shades. I tested them out. I have the undertones, and so hopefully all that was helpful for you if you did see the video. The main thing I like about Urban Decay, and I've said that, you know, well before I started receiving any type of product from the brand. What I love about Urban Decay's concealers is that they layer well with powders, whether using pressed or loose powder. I can apply some powder to set it and then go in to cover the mark or whatnot, and it will stay. It will last. So I did use their all-nighter in a corrector shade for me, so I can use that. I also have one to contour because, again, it's one that's going to give me that rich, deep color, you know, carve out whatever I'm trying to carve out, but I know the concealer is going to stay. It's not going to be going all over the place, and it creates a nice, realistic contour. For the powder category, I tend to reach for loose powders more over pressed. I still reach for my Coty, same as last year and the year prior. Coty Airspun Naturally Loose Powder, Naturally Neutral is the shade. If you have darker skin, you're my skin tone, this is truly colorless. So they have different colors like translucent, extra coverage. Those are best for lighter skin because it's actually kind of like it has a foundation shade to it. You want naturally neutral. Absolutely fabulous. Cannot be without it. Slight smell, doesn't bother me. I really do enjoy that one. For my high-end pick, this was easy. It's the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Loose Setting Powder. It's a baking powder that stayed in my mind. I mean, when I did the dedicated review for this powder, I'm still using the sample that my girlfriend gave me. She's on their PR. So from that time, I've already gone down here. So that's how much I have. This powder will not dry underneath your eyes. So you're not going to look like that if you do bake. It just smooths everything out. And when I was doing my wear test and showing it in that video, I mean, you can see I got all close and personal. It's not cakey. It's not getting into the lines. It just smooths everything out. I can wear it all over my face. My shade is in the shade Kunafa. I can put it all over my face, set it that way, light dust, put it in with a puff, put it on with a sponge, and I mean it looks beautiful and it's skin light. Next up is bronzer, and here's where I have a high-end drugstore as well as a luxury pick. My drugstore pick will go to e.l.f. and this is in the shade Deep. This was just by itself, no special little packaging here, just real simple at my Walmart, and I'm like, I see a dark powder. What is that? This color, look at that. It has that slight red tint that I love. It has a slight sheen to it as well. It was, what, $1, $2? Very inexpensive. But for the price, the fact that this bronzer actually blends out without, you know, patchiness, it's just, ooh, Now, my high-end pick goes to one that I noticed that every time I would wear it, it just gives me this definition to my cheeks. Like I've mentioned before, when I put bronzer on my cheeks, makes my blush pop, really just gives me that warmth for my skin. This is just so good. And it's from Laura Geller. It's the Baked Bronze in Brighten. I'm in the shade medium. Darkness of the actual matte bronzer, there's a lot of it in here. Then you swirl it together and it's mixing in with the medium tone. Then it's mixing in with the light one and mixing in a little bit with the pink. It is something I will pick up a full size of, although I don't know when, because I have not made a dent in that small size. My luxury pick is for Kevin Aucoin. This is the Celestial, what's the exact title? The Celestial Bronzing Veil, and then Tropical Nights, which is a cool bronze. Great about Tropical Nights is it's a cool tone brown based bronzer that actually will not look gray on my warm skin. That's another thing that will counteract on my skin, my undertone. This is the only one that I have personally have found that's a cool tone brown that will give me that rich definition, almost as if it is a red based one, even though it's not, and just complements my undertone. This is why I really like it. It fades, so, and then Kevin's Celestial products tend to do that. It'll go light to dark. I can still swirl it all and even get the light color, and it still will give me a stronger application. It's just perfect. And last for bronzers is actually a cream-based formula. Now this is actually a contour stick. This is from the brand Models Own, but I have been using it as a cream bronzer all of last year. This is a number one Sundown, and for a contour stick, let's just first start there. This, it's the only one shade. There's only one shade for this. This is very red, so I was actually surprised when I saw this in the Ulta store. I was thinking, how does the brand think that Fair Skin is going to use this to contour? I mean, it's just very a red based cream, but perfect for darker skin as far as a cream formula if you're into that. I'm very much into cream formulas, so this is a wonderful cream stick bronzer. It's all matte, so no shimmer. And for something that is very rare, I feel, in a cream format for darker skin, definitely jumped on it. Now for my second favorite category to apply to my face, and that is highlighter. And I have quite a few as far as splitting it out by formula, because I use liquid, I use drops, and then I use a palette. So I have one for each one. So let's go by that. Drugstore top pick goes to Pixi by Petra. I do receive Pixi products from time to time. So when I tried these out last year, wet, wet, wet. They come in two shades. I have Subtle Sunrise as well as Delicate Dew. If you like that strong highlight appearance, but something that still looks like it's part of your skin, this is definitely the way to go. My high-end pick for a liquid highlighter is something that I use from Becca, and I make it look like a liquid highlighter. This is actually the Backlight Priming Filter. So I'm actually still using their deluxe size sample, and I also have a full size as well. When I use this on my skin alone as an actual primer all over my skin, I do feel that it's too much, and that's just my personal preference. So what I started to do was just play around and see how I like it. And when I just use it as that highlight effect, as I like to do with my cream highlighters, that is where I started to see the shine. This just, it offers that appearance where it just melts into your skin as one, and then I can go ahead and put my regular highlighter on top. So for today's video, that's exactly what I did. For a luxury version, this was also an easy pick for me. This goes back to Kevin Aucoin. So Kevin's making quite a few appearances here for 2018. This is the Celestial Skin Liquid Highlighter. My shade is in, and what does it say? I know it's more of that bronze look. Sunlight is my shade here. This is, again, something that you can mix in with your foundation if you like. You can pinpoint it for that light effect, which is how I prefer to use it. That's what I recommend, is when you're looking at liquids, try to see how you want to fit it in your overall routine. Don't just necessarily go by what it's marketed for. You make up your own rules. Now this goes and blends into the skin quite nice, like that. See how it starts to go down as far as that subtle appearance? So you can put it on your body as well. But it's a liquid highlighter. This one from Kevin just takes the cake. It's just so beautiful. It also doesn't bunch up underneath makeup. So if I wanted to apply it on top of foundation, even on top of powder, it still remains in the liquid consistency. Looks fabulous on the skin. I do have a palette. This is one that I have been reaching for the most last year. Very pleased with the formula. And this is from Huda Beauty. It's the 3D highlighter palette. The shade that I got is Bronze Sands Edition. Here we go. I can just use the cream instead of using the liquid drop. You know, I just kind of change it every time I do the makeup. And then these shades are just made for darker skin. Maldives, Aruba, and Bora Bora. So just beautiful. Beautiful. The formula is, again, something that's very smooth. It's not overly shimmery. There's no glitter particles getting all over the place. It's just a great highlighter palette. Let's move on to blushes. My drugstore pick goes to L'Oreal, their Paradise Enchanted Scented Blushes. I have really been enjoying these. What is unusual, I feel, about this blush, or just how it looks on my skin tone, is I will start to have the actual blush color, like right here, but then as it starts to kind of creep over into the cheekbone, I see that soft, like, highlighted effect. So these blushes look great as far as if I wanted to do it like as a topper on top of other matte blushes. My high-end pick will go to the Anastasia Beverly Hills Blush Kit. The one I use the most is the deeper shade one here. This is Ingredient, and then this one is the Radiant one. I use this shade here. If I'm using a cream contour, I will set it with this. This does not turn gray on my skin, so I like that. And then I can just go all the, you know, pick the brush, go right through these two shades. Sometimes I'll just go all three, so I like that. And then I tend to use this one by itself, that deep, rich plum blackberry shade right there. So I do like this. So happy I got both of them. They're very interchangeable, and they look beautiful on the skin. Blends well. I just love them. Now let's move to the eyes, the eyeshadow, mascara. Let's blow all that out. I'm gonna first start off with eye primer. Now for drugstore eye primer, now this has been this way for quite some time. I just haven't found one that I personally like the most. And a lot of the reason why is there's something in the ingredients with the drugstore ones that burn my skin. For high-end eye primer, I use a lot of times my Urban Decay Anti-Aging Potion one or the original one. Those I really enjoy. But for 2018, I have two as far as the formula. One is a lot more lighter than the other. This is Smashbox Photo Finish Lid Primer. So this one is the light. This one is the medium. Medium is more my skin tone, so it just goes onto my lid, starts to cancel any discoloration. It's very much like it's a concealer. So this will actually, I can dry it down and then leave it. I don't have to set it if I don't want to. That's another reason why I like this. And then go ahead and apply my eyeshadow. But even when I set this with a very light dusting of loose powder, because I have oily eyelids, so I have to always set it, it still will blend out the shadow well. For eyeshadow palettes, I picked Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam Palette. Now, this is a palette where it crossed over and met a lot of my needs, and that was where I was saying, okay, it's got to be this. So meaning if I left the house, I wasn't coming back, I wanted just no-brainer. No-brainer, don't want to deal with my makeup. Because sometimes I like that. I'm just like, I don't want to deal with it. I need to hurry up and go. I will grab the Soft Glam. I have this color Sultry all over my lid here, but I put a black base on. So if you put bases on these powders as well, they just amp it up. I have Bronze as my tear duct, Mulberry, you have that nice black there. So it's just very versatile. You have your lighter shade here just to put on your brow bone. This is just a no-brainer to me. So I know that no matter where I'm at, no matter how I'm going to use this palette, it's going to look, I'm going to be very pleased with my eye look. So this is definitely my favorite all-time pick for 2018. Eyeliner pencil, nothing from the drugstore, still using what I have. However, for a high-end brand, I do have my favorite pencil. And this is one that I actually picked up at the beginning part of January, remember. This is Urban Decay's 24/7 Waterproof Liquid Liner. This brush is super, super fine tip. So you can get right up to that lash line. I mean, the closest you can get to. The color is rich and it's black. That's what I want, just as black as can be. I need to know if this is still part of the lineup. If not, I'm going back to Nordstrom Rack and buy up a couple more. For eyebrows, my drugstore pick is a pencil that I have one here, one there, one everywhere. This is from e.l.f. It's just the brow pencils. This is another find I picked up at Walmart. I think it's $1, $1.02. It reminds me like I'm working with a dip pomade, like a pomade substance, like ABH. That is why I like this pencil. It quickly fills in whatever areas I might need, quickly filling in. It's done and I'm out the door. My high-end pick is Benefits Precisely Any Brow. No, Precisely My Brow Pencil, excuse me. It's precisely going to go in the lines and create some sharp wings, sharp arches, if that's, you know, how you want your brows to look. It's a great pencil. The formula is great as well. Just, it stays put. Which brings me to the next Benefit product I discovered, and I'm not putting it down. I am not putting it down. The Cabrow. This is number 6 as well. Yep, number 6. This is actually, the title is the Cream Gel Brow. I just warm up the gel in here and it just applies so good. It will fill in quickly. It will create some sharp lines. It's just such a great product. Moving on to mascara, I'm actually just gonna read from my notes because I don't have the product actually here. It's a drugstore version. It is Maybelline's Big Shot Mascara. So that's the mascara where I feel it just does it all. It'll lengthen, it'll give me some volume, it'll give me some thickness. I feel my lashes look good. Whether I'm going to wear false lashes with it or not, it will mesh well with that. And it's not something where it's like overly wet, takes forever to dry. It's a really good mascara. So that was definitely my top pick. Now for a high-end one, I'm going to mention this one because it's the high-end one where I was like, if it did not flake, I would be paying the money and I have to have the Kush. That's what it is, the Milk Kush Mascara. Boy, my lashes look like I have on false lashes. It's the only mascara where, definitely high-end, where I'm like, you know what? This is rivaling my luxury version one that I've always used, my Guerlain. So, Kush. Love it. Another big category is lips and lipsticks and lip liners and lip gloss. So I'm first going to start off with the Bullet lipstick. So my drugstore pick, this was easy. This goes to CoverGirl. Their lipsticks are creamy. This is actually my favorite formula within their line. Also, their lipsticks have that like vanilla smell, like a MAC lipstick. So I do like that. My high-end pick for lipstick goes to Fenty. So Plush Matte Lipsticks. This is going to be a reoccurring theme you'll see with me, or excuse me, here, is I want my lipsticks to feel comfortable. I don't care about the formula. If they're comfortable, that is what I'm looking for. And I have a luxury one. So for this luxury lipstick, I will go out and buy myself another one. I've also already picked out Givenchy's Rouge lipsticks, the little baby sets they have, because they have this color in it. Number 13, you pull it out, you know, with the little like tuxedo, little ribbon there, and this is that red. Oh, I just can't put this down. This color is so pretty on my lips. It has that, I think it's that black rose oil as far as the smell, but it's not a luxury lipstick. Like some luxury lipsticks have that strong fragrance to it. This isn't strong at all. Moving on to lip gloss. Usually when it comes to lip gloss from a drugstore, I don't go that route. And it's really just because I figure I'll just go ahead and get my lip gloss that I've been getting. And that's from ColourPop. So I'm going to include ColourPop, even though it's not 2018. Their glosses are perfect as far as affordable gloss. I don't mind the wand. The colors are beautiful. My high-end pick was easy. The lip gloss is Urban Decay's Hi-Fi Gloss. These are the two shades that is always in my everyday makeup bag. So it's Fuel and 1993. Perfect. Perfect everyday colors. I love this minty feeling that I get on my lips when I put this on. It smells good. It feels good on the lips. There's that tingle. It goes away. But I mean, these glosses are fabulous. Tons of colors. This is something I've done a review on. Swatched them all on my lips. Shown them. Now for liquid lipstick. This is a category where, again, I'm going to be looking at Comfort. Drugstore pick goes to, not allowed anymore, Maybelline's Stay Matte Ink. This is just a wonderful drugstore liquid lipstick that I've noticed lasts, and I can also reapply it. And if I reapply it, let's say after eating or drinking, it doesn't look all crusty. It doesn't look all gathered and bunched up and in the line. And my high-end pick for liquid lipsticks goes to Dose of Colors. Dose of Colors is the brand where I was. What you got? I'm paying attention to what you have in your lineup. This is another comfortable liquid lipstick. Doses Liquids also is another formula where I can reapply it and it's not looking all gathering, crusty, and all that. For lip liners, my drugstore pick goes again to CoverGirl. So you have a ton of colors here, but the main difference is this is the older version. This is the one that I have. This is in the shade Beloved. So you had to sharpen it, and the formula wasn't as opaque as I would have preferred. Now with their whole redesign, you have just the twist up ones, and they're at a slant here. So it's very easy to get a nice crisp line, definitely by using the sides here. I also noticed that not only is the formula quite opaque, it will stay. It does not feather, it does not bleed. So definitely a big step up from what they used to have. Next up is false lashes. This is the style that I would buy. This is from the brand Kiss, and it's actually the blowout lashes. So look for the one that has the actual blow dryer on it. The style that I prefer is Pixie 02. This has that little bit of glamour that I like, but the actual ends kind of curl up and it blends well with my own naturally curly lashes. This is my favorite style. They have other styles, but Pixie's where it's at. My lash glue choice from last year is from the brand Pure. It's their Pro Eyelash Glue. This is their cruelty-free, well, it's a cruelty-free brand to begin with. I really do enjoy the Pure because it has a strong hold, but it also is one of those glues that is not going to have the irritating ingredients in it. So if you're allergic to lash glue, if you get skin irritation along your lash line, just all types of issues that might come with, you know, like more of the popular glue, then this is something I would recommend you give a shot. Setting sprays. Drugstore. Still using what I already have. There wasn't one that was just wowing me. For high end, my top pick is a Radiant one, of course, but let me get there. Let me first say it. Glam Glow Glow Setter Makeup Setting Spray. It's not so radiant and dewy where, let's say, you have oily skin. It's going to be just all over your face. This is something that sets the makeup and just adds the right amount of radiance to the skin. I love it. I cannot be without this spray. Two more categories and we're done. This one is where I would pick like my favorite tool, or maybe like last year it was a mirror, my Daiso mirror, which is floating around here somewhere. But I do have a beauty tool, well actually two, that I definitely have to let you know that I'm not going to stop using them. I really enjoy them, and they suit the purpose for what I'm trying to do. So first up is the Stands Out Beauty Company's Makeup Blending Sponge. So the nice, soft, squishy little cut of wedge right there. I actually have two, so this is my second one. I mainly use this for foundation. I can use it for concealer. I feel it's a little bit too big for that, but I do like it where I need something a little bit sharper and cut. Like if I really want to apply targeted area of highlight, then I can use it to do that. Then it washes clean except for a few stains. So I know that this might have been like a gimmick when it first came out, but I don't mind stuff like that. You know, if it works, it works. If I find a purpose for it, I don't care if it's a gimmick or not. And if I like it, then I will keep it. This one is a gimmick, or everyone was thinking it was a gimmick, and it's still something I use. I mean, I don't think a lot of people use this still, but I do. I use my Silly Sponge every time I reach for my ColourPop face products. That's what I use it for. And actually, I take that back. Any type of like a creamy type texture where I really want it to be bold, that is when I use this, because it just picks it up and I just go bup, 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 smooth it out. There's no finger marks left by this. My last mention is, and this is where I'm going to start doing this for this year, is I think of the brand that I have been just not only ordering the most from or buying in store from, I just have noticed, you know what? I just can't pull away. I keep looking what you got, what do you have? And I noticed for 2018, and I have the receipts to show it, definitely has been ColourPop. Fair warning, a warning to all the brands out there, not just drugstore, all of them, high-end and luxury. ColourPop is coming for all of your necks. All of them. Get ready. They got you by the throat. Because I know people think that, or they've been saying, ColourPop is just releasing products like that, you know, which is true. What I've noticed is, regardless of it, whether it's like this, when I get the product, the quality is there. I may not like everything right off the top of my head, the liquid foundation, but majority of what I try from ColourPop, it's great. So this is what I'm saying. I look and I'm just like, you know what? We need this. And boom, they pull it out. Mascara, here it comes. The Glittery Obsessed. Oh God, I love this. You know, and I mean, just the palettes, the liquid lipsticks even. I gotta tell you, ColourPop is where I spent a lot of my money for 2018. And I'm here for it. I'm here for it. They want to grab everybody? Go ahead. I'm here for it. Because at the end of the day, the quality is there. At the end of the day, the price is right. And isn't that what we're looking for? So continue on, ColourPop. You know, I look. If it's not something I want to get, I don't give it. Simple. And keep it moving, because the next day or the next week, something else new will come out. So that's the brand that was the most purchased and in my collection for 2018. And that's it. Those are my top picks for 2018. I hope some of these are already in your makeup collection, some you're already using. This is very fun to do. And I start keeping track early, like in January. And then I'll put little notes in my phone based on if my mind has changed about something, so that way I can remember it come at the end of the year. But these are my favorites. And again, remember, this is specific also to me and how I wear my makeup. So I hope it's been helpful for you in any way. Everything is linked in the info box, along with links if you want to use those links. I will get a small commission from it, but you don't have to. Shop any way you like. Thank you very much for stopping by and watching, everyone. As always, I greatly appreciate it. Have a wonderful day or evening. And as always, I'm going to see you in the next video. Goodbye.